Bat Blitz 2012 was conducted here on the Apalachicola National Forest. For 3 days, 90 biologists from state and private and federal agencies met on the forest to capture bats and examine their health in the forest. In the 3 days, we captured 245 bats, and we got a baseline study of how the bats are doing on the forest, and they all appeared to be healthy.
So we've determined potential bat foraging sites, sites where the bats are going to be out at night going after their food. And then within those sites, we pick sites where we can put in a mist net. And that's our main method of capture for this blitz this year. And the bats, when they're out there foraging, they find their way by echolocation, sending out sound waves. If it hits something, it bounces back, and they hear their own voice. And that tells them what objects are in front of them. Well, with the mist net, they don't get a lot of echo off of it. And so they tend to write it off as feedback, and they continue to fly forward. And then they get tangled into the strings of that mist net.
We're here tonight with a small group of biologists and ecologists trying to capture bats over a creek. We have caught two bats already tonight, a Seminole and a red bat, and we're hoping to catch a few more.
Very good. This is a different species than the other two. This is an evening bat. Because they live in large colonies and not as clean and neat as some of our other bats. We've got the forearm is 39. And now we're gonna take her and put her in a hauling bag for a little while so we can collect some guano. With the external morphology here, this is actually their foot. This foot that is real small, you can see, and their wing is actually a modified hand. This is the thumb, and these are the fingers. The wing membrane itself is, you can see, it's kind of rubbery, almost about like a latex glove or something. Just a thin layer of skin between the finger bones. And this particular bat, this is a Seminole bat, and it's heavily furred. This guy's a male, as you can see. And a nice, very dark bat, very thick fur. You can see their little tiny teeth. Like all of our bats here, they're insectivores. Although I guess in very southern Florida, there are some fruit-eating bats. These guys are tree roosters. They roost in canopies. Often they, well, actually the Seminole bat is roost in Spanish moss. So these guys will climb up in a clump of Spanish moss and roost during the day. And then when they come out at night, they drop out and fly and start foraging.